Another crunch is coming. The big question this morning, just how painful will it be? In just a few hours' time, the Reserve Bank will announce another expected rise in interest rates, pushing millions more Aussies into mortgage stress as the pressure on household budgets grows. So let's discuss with Federal Education Minister Jason Clare. Good morning to you. And 4BC's Scott Emerson in Brisbane. Now, Minister, let's start with you. It's shaping up to be the perfect storm, isn't it? You come into office with rising fuel costs, grocery prices, housing crisis, the prospect of interest rate rises. A big job ahead. Like, what are you going to do to try and ease the cost of living for Australians?
We've got inflation through the roof. Wages are through the floor. We've got interest rates now knocking at the door. We can't preempt what the Reserve Bank's going to say or do today, but they've made it pretty clear there's going to be a number of interest rate rises, and that just makes it harder for people who've got big mortgages already, particularly for people who've just signed up to a mortgage in the last 12 months. Mm. For a lot of Aussies, they're ahead in their mortgage, but if you've just signed up and then the bank tells you you've got to pay more, it's going to make it harder and harder. Now, there's no simple magic fix to this. There are some measures that the former government put in the budget which we support, but we need some medium and long-term measures to help get wages going again and help people with the cost of living, whether it's childcare or the cost of medicine or the cost of energy. But it's hard. There is no simple fix here.
Yeah, Scott, it's all right to put the squeeze on spending, isn't it? But if the spending is on things that you can't avoid buying, like food and fuel, you know, how is this going to help?
Oh, look, it's going to be so hard for so many people. And Jason's right in terms of those who have just got into the mortgage market. But when you're talking about, say, a lettuce for 12 bucks, I mean, and interest rates going up, Jason mentioned about getting wages up. Of course, if wages go up to the inflation rate, as the government is forecasting and they want to do, well, that's only going to put more pressure on inflation. That means interest rates will go up even higher. We already know that Philip Lowe is talking about 2% by roughly the end of this year. So we could see a rise today, 0.4, maybe even 0.5, taking up to 0.85% of interest rates. That's going to hurt a lot of people there.
It certainly is. Now, let's move on. In the last few moments, Boris Johnson has given his reaction to surviving a vote of no confidence. Let's have a listen to that.
Since I think it's a convincing result, a decisive result, and what it means is that as a government, we can move on and focus on the stuff that I think really matters.
Oh, it didn't even convince me then. Minister, we know about spills in Australia.
We do, unfortunately.
We know what's going to happen here, don't we?
Yeah, if history's any guide, then this is not the end of it. I think when the same thing happened to Margaret Thatcher, when the same thing happened to Theresa May, they won this initial vote, but they end up resigning soon after. The same thing we've seen in Australia, I think, more recently with Malcolm Turnbull. He's only just won this. I think almost half of his party voted against him. You know, obviously, his party are as angry as I'm sure the general public are that when you tell people not to do something, you know, to sacrifice things like Christmas and then you go off and have parties, it has a political impact, and that's obviously biting in the UK at the moment.
Oh, it certainly is. I mean, Scott, the population has certainly spoken, hasn't it? You've seen the booing there at the Jubilee. It seems like they don't want a bar of him.
Look, Bojo is toast. That's just the reality of it. How long he'll limp on for, it's hard to say. He's got two by-elections coming up at the end of this month. The Tories are likely to lose those. Theresa May, she limped on for a while. Margaret Thatcher did so. John Major actually got to an election after he had a vote of no confidence. He'd won. But, look, I can't see Bojo surviving. And clearly, the UK population doesn't want him there. He has clearly flouted the rules that he brought in. It didn't apply to him. And I think once you have that situation, the public believes you don't abide by the rules that everyone else is expected to follow, well, you can't survive as leader.
Now, let's move on to another unpopular leader. It's Russian President Vladimir Putin, who's been surprisingly invited to the G20 summit in Bali. So I'm just imagining, Minister, if he does attend, nobody's going to want to shake his hand or be photographed with him.
Well, no one would want to sit next to him, you know, not after everything that he's done. Remember, this is a person who's authorised the blowing up of hospitals, the bombing of childcare centres and kindergartens, rape, murder and torture of women and children. I don't think anybody really wants him there. No one would want to sit next to him. But it's important that we go to the G20 because it's an important event. It's held in Indonesia, which is one of our best friends in the world. It's important also to note, Leila, that President Zelensky's been invited as well.
Ah.
And that's a good thing.
Yes.
I think everybody will want to shake his hand.
Yeah. Will we see Zelensky there? Will we see Putin there? What do you think, Scott?
Oh, look, I think this is a really difficult one for a lot of the world leaders there, because I can't imagine a situation that Wheaton, Anthony Albanese, is there standing in the group photo then with Vladimir Putin. Or Joe Biden is accused Vladimir Putin of being a war criminal. And then, what, turn up to an event with him? I can't imagine that anyone wants Putin there, but given his view of the world, he will turn up. And the trouble is, he will use it to justify to the Russian people that the world does accept me as a leader, a legitimate leader, rather than a war criminal who's overseen the atrocities in Ukraine. So it's going to be a very difficult one for Anthony Albanese to be in that group photo. What's he not? He's going to step out of it and say, no, I'm not going to be there with him? Or what happens if, unfortunately, he is standing next to Vladimir Putin at one of those events?
Yeah, awkward. Reminds me of that Chinese curse this morning's chat, that we're living in interesting times, aren't we?
Indeed.
All right, Minister Scott Emerson, thank you for joining me this morning.